It's too late to change events. It's time to face the consequence for delivering the proof in the policy of truth. Denver Broncos Mile High View, no commercials, and always, always absolutely no bullshit here. So here I am, doing a video that I knew I would be doing called In Defense of Joe Flacco. Now, if you go back, you know that I was not at all in favor of bringing Joe Flacco in. And I said that even though I'm not in favor, I will end up having to defend him from the same old tired message that is out there when things don't go right. Because we have people that think they're football analysts, Bronco analysts, and they just give you the same tired message. You know, they gave you all the hype. You know, these are the same people that hyped up the Broncos, that hyped up the defense. And remember, it was me. Again, this lone voice out here, you know, for some reason that seems to be right a lot, but gets ignored a lot too, because nobody wants to hear the truth. Nobody wants to hear, you know, what's going on. So obviously I'm not shocked the Broncos are going this way. I didn't think it would be this bad, but maybe there's a lot more turmoil in that locker room and in that with the coaching and everything else than, you know, meets the eye. Well, the people over at the Huddle are, you know, I was reading on the Bleacher Report, are trying to push the same old message, which is, you know, bench Joe Flacco. So again, we're this is the Broncos where quarterbacks go to die. The same tired message. Bench Joe Flacco, bring in Locke, as if that's going to do anything. And what really this means is what they're really trying to tell you is we know Locke will end up failing most likely. So this will give us so by the time about three quarters of the season through, we can start petitioning for the Broncos to draft be up for the quarterback in the draft, as if that's really going to do anything either. And it's fine. They can, in my book, they can draft a quarterback. It's one or half a dozen of the other, but that isn't going to solve the Broncos' real problems. But let's go back to the argument with Joe Flacco and the loss to the Jacksonville Jaguars. What really got me about the Huddle's incorrect analysis was they said that the offensive line did good. You have to be really on crack to think that offensive line was doing good, and it wasn't Joe Flacco making that line look a whole lot better than they were. And this is the same line that was allowing, you know, defensive 6 foot, I don't know, what was he, 6 foot seven defensive lineman just to come in unblocked. This is the same offensive line that the Huddle is defending. Joe Flacco was doing what I've been pounding the table from before week one that he has to do, because the offensive line is shit. And that is, he has to get rid of the ball quick, and that's what he did. He doesn't have a choice. If you notice that, not only were they letting people in, but the offensive line was collapsing immediately upon the hiking of the ball. Joe Flacco was getting the ball within that three-second window that I said that he has to do, because they just do not have the personnel. And I'm saying that, you know, this isn't a benching Joe Flacco or a playing lock situation. This is the lines must be replaced. You keep Reisner, you get rid of everybody else on that offensive line. I don't know why you would sign Juwan James, a guy that notoriously spends time in the hot tub. Just like, why would you sign Callahan? You know, to all that money, so he can, you know, skip basically the year. We don't know if that foot surgery is going to be if he's going to be the same guy after the foot surgery. You know, these are the things that you got to ask. Chris Harris Jr.'s pissed off because he's out there making plays while the guy that got the big contract sitting in the hot tub time machine. You know, so you can't blame him for that. Elway continues to mismanage the free agency. And it probably is the quarterback that probably has to go is really, quite frankly, Elway. I think that, you know, Munchak and Fangio, if we can get them to bring in both not just draft picks. This is beyond draft picks. Rebuilding the team, you're going to have to bring in some free agents too. But they're going to have to bring their guys in. Remember what I said at the beginning of the season? They're inheriting a mess. I couldn't understand why Fangio would even sign with the Broncos. And everybody, boy, did I get thumbs down for that. How dare you? We're not the Cleveland Browns, are we? No, we're not. The Cleveland Browns are actually a better team than the Broncos. So, as I cited the Cleveland Browns, you know, just this whole, you know, going through quarterbacks like socks kind of thing and just getting draft picks. Well, you got to have free agents too. And Elway sucks in the free agent. But of course, I don't know if Juwan James was a Musgrave thing or was that an Elway thing, because I questioned that move from the beginning. And, you know, he's, again, this week four, he's still in the hot tub. And again, he would make these appearances and then end up back on the injured. So why do you sign those players when there were other offensive linemen that were actually better before they went away? It just, I don't, you know, there's a disconnect, I think, with the front office with players. But, you know, again, the tired message is blame the quarterback. And a quarterback that actually was making the offense or the line look better than it really is. Say that the line was somehow doing its job, which, you know, it looked good in the first half of the first quarter when they were doing some misdirection. It looked good. It looked at its best, but then they got away from that, and you could blame that on Scangarello. But I'm sick and tired of these incorrect analysis, and it's the same old thing over and over again that goes nowhere, that fixes and solves nothing. You know, do you want to get rid of the Chris Harris Juniors? You know, he did get burned a couple times, you know? So I don't see why he has what he has. And he got, you know, Manchu the mustache, you know, I think scored a touchdown. It was the Bears, I remember. And then this, I didn't see the Green Bay game, but, you know, he can't sit there and say, he has nothing to say because he's getting burned too. He's not really doing his job as well. But then again, he's not getting line support too. So, I mean, it's just, you know, it is what it is. This team has to start building the lines. I'm not opposed to getting a quarterback in the 2020 draft. Why don't we just say it now? Instead of going through the stupid lock process, put the tombstone and bury Flacco, rip, rest in peace, another quarterback we killed. And Locke, okay, well, you know, he's not going to, I have no faith in him at this point, especially watching him in preseason, holding on to the ball, not knowing, you know, on third string defenses, NFL being confused. You know, he's not going to emerge. And plus, he doesn't have the offensive line support. I don't want to just see him running around, you know. We need to get the lines fixed. So why don't we just stop the bullshit and go get yourself another quarterback and Locke and this other new quarterback and fight it out. In the meantime, let's start really getting serious at building the lines. I'm going to keep pounding the table for that. I'm going to be the lone voice again who always somehow seems to be right and goes against the same old tired message that's out there.